Broadcasting live from the Business Radio X studios in Atlanta, Georgia, it's time for GWBC Radio's Open for Business. Now, here's your host.
Hey, Lee Cantor here, another episode of Open for Business, GWBC Radio's show where we spotlight business owners doing amazing things that are part of the GWBC community, and this show will be no exception. We got today Hope White with HD White Logistics. Welcome, Hope.
Hi, how are you doing today?
We are doing well. How about you? Tell us about HD White Logistics. How are you serving folks?
So we are a third-party logistics provider here out of McDonough. We provide trucking assets in the form of dry van, flatbed, and reefer. Since COVID-19, we have been supporting our small businesses and nonprofit organizations with truckload services to help move some of those COVID supplies. So that's how we've been doing our part here with COVID-19.
Yeah, so that has disrupted a lot of industries, a lot of organizations. Have you had to make any kind of drastic changes in your operation, any pivots since this crisis began?
Yeah, definitely we've done some pivots. So we are working from home. We're working virtually, which is working out pretty well because we can do everything from the internet as well. It did impact some of our marketing and sales piece because we did do a lot of conferences and networking events. So we've had to return to, of course, LinkedIn and then set up Zoom calls of that nature. And then from the sales perspective or business perspective, we were onboarding with maybe 3 or 4 very large contracts. And when COVID hit, everything ceased. And we understand, you know, what happened, but we lost a great deal of sales there when COVID hit.
Right. And that's one of those things where it's no fault of anybody, no fault mm-hmm. of anything but the circumstance that we're in. And then a lot of businesses have had to adjust and create additional kind of revenue streams, some of them out of thin air. Do you have anything going on where you're able to create revenue while not doing some of that work that you had already planned to do?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So one of my other revenue streams is training and consulting. And so although COVID took our mainstream out, I was able to create a product of an online course, which I probably had been putting off for a little while, but an online course for training for any people who are interested or companies that are currently in logistics and transportation, understanding the industry. So I actually launched an online course as well as a consulting piece to my business. So that has picked up tremendously. We've actually done 2 other podcasts on large supply chain platforms. And so that has really been driving us forward and keeping us afloat.
And those are good lessons for business owners out there that some of those things that were on the back burner, you might want to move to the front burner and and then just kind of play it out and see. You never know, because when this thing ends, and it will end, that could be a part of your business going forward that, you know, maybe you had thought you'd like to do, but now is now just kind of an active part of your revenue streams.
Right. Definitely. Definitely. Like I really, just to be honest, I procrastinated on that online class forever. I put up all kind of blocks and fears, which we tend to do as entrepreneurs, just give ourselves all these blocks. But when COVID happened and I had to scale back and sit down, per se, there was no other excuses then but to do it. And it actually took me about 2 weeks. My first launch was a little rocky. We had some challenges with the launch of the website, but we all have time now. And so we've just went back, rebuilt the site, and everything's going successful now. So that definitely will be going forward a consistent piece of the business now, the consulting and the training piece.
Now, you mentioned that relationships are important in your work during normal times. And you mentioned maybe you're active on different channels or maybe using them more, maybe more often or more frequently nowadays. Can you talk about maybe some tips for our listeners on how to kind of keep up those relationships and stay top of mind during this crisis?
So part of my business, which is logistics, my business is logistics and transportation. Most people focus on sales. Sales. I've always been at HD White Logistics a relationship person. And right now, what the world needs is relationships and empathy. Not fake empathy, but true, genuine empathy. My clients that are coming to me now or my students that I partner with now, I've just advised that in order to move your business forward during COVID and after COVID is to come with your arms extended out to your potential customers or those that are in need. Have your hands extended out with help, with the solution, and not necessarily add to the problem that's currently going on. And so we've been able to continue a lot of the relationships that we were already building because we're now providing solutions to those customers in a way that they weren't already prepared for with COVID-19.
Now, has this opened up maybe new partnerships or maybe looking at some kind of complementary business people that maybe you weren't working with? Maybe now you introduce yourself and build a relationship around?
Absolutely. My business specialty is drive-in freight, like retail, groceries, electronics, some flatbed. And then we had just gotten into heavy haul services, low boys and step decks, which I know some people that's probably a little foreign to, but that's what we had taken on prior to COVID. Well, since COVID, when COVID hit, a lot of truckers or the logistics industry pivoted towards the essential items, leaving the non-essential items available to still need work. And so we have now stepped over into the pool of hazmat because, you know, you had those chemical loads, the chemical companies that were still needing that freight moved or cargo moved, and we were there to assist. So then now we've added a new specialty, which is hazmat freight.
And that's brand new to your organization, right? Like this is now an opportunity that you were able to kind of serve that market. And then again, this is when this thing's over, now that's another tool in your tool belt, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's another tool in our tool belt. We're going to season that that tool and definitely push it forward after COVID as well. So I know some people, you know, not with the health side of it, but from a business perspective, some people have kind of been dim. And it's because I feel like they weren't prepared and no one was really prepared. Let me not say that. But I want to encourage everyone to take the opportunity to pivot and look into those things that you had fear behind in your business. And those are actually the things that will help you sustain during this time.
Now, let's talk about your training opportunity that you've opened up. You built this course. Who is the ideal kind of learner for this course?
Okay, so my consulting is hopewhiteconsulting.com. And the ideal clientele for my course is those who are currently in the industry. So a driver, a supply chain corporate associate who's wanted to come out of supply chain from logistics and want to start their own logistics company and not really understanding how it works on the entrepreneur side, or a family run trucking company that they want to scale the business to the next level, take it maybe from the carrier side to the broker side or even warehousing or cross docking side, understanding that piece of the industry. So we're kind of diverse with our customers, but maybe the entry level, maybe season owner, operator in logistics, transportation, and then your corporate entities that's want to coming out of the corporate role into their own business.
And then by taking this course, how will that help them either create additional revenue or maybe just give them more context in the business? Like what's the benefit of taking the course? What can they expect?
So my course, my background, let me give a little bit of background about me. I'm from supply chain. I worked with big box retail for 5 years, actually in logistics and transportation. And so what I found, my personal experience coming out trying to start my own business, particularly in freight brokering and transportation, on the private side, information and education is limited. The resources, people weren't so open to giving, I guess you could say, the tricks of the trade. With my course and with partnering with me, I actually have a genuine passion to help people understand the industry so that ultimately we provide the end goal to the customer, which is the best service. Coming from Home Depot, working for 5 years, in that role, I noticed that there were a lot of logistics providers that the dollar was the goal versus the service to the goal. So coming, working with my organization and learning from me, you learn how to have a sustained long-term logistics business versus just chasing the dollar. And so we provide the who, what, when, why, and where of logistics, how to get started, what happens when your business gets started, who's your target customer, specialize in your market, invoicing, sales. We go through everything. I even offer long-term consulting services after the course. So it's not a one-time, just come learn the information and you're done. For the life of the relationship, the student has access to our services to help them be successful in their business.
Now, how long does it take to complete the course?
So we offer two different course types. We offer online and we offer in-person. The in-person course is a 4-day course hosted here in Atlanta. It's 4 days, it's 4 days, 8 hours, and it's 5 different instructors. And then the online course, it's 4 different packages. So it depends on what the student is wanting. Some people already have some knowledge coming to us. We understand that. So we broke the packages out. But the online course goes from 2 hours all the way up to a 16-hour online course that can be split across 3 or 4 days. Just depends on the student. It's self-paced.
So you can go at your own pace. So you can...
It's self-paced. So you may take those 16 hours and turn them into 8. It's up to you.
Right. So now talk about GWBC. How have they helped you through this crisis and helped you grow your business?
Wow. So GWBC is probably one of the best decisions that I could have ever made for my business, becoming a member. GWBC during this crisis has kept me informed as far as the financial piece with the benefits of applying for the SBA loans and grants and awards that's out there. Making sure that I'm keeping my brand facing forward for my customers or potential customers that's out there. And then GWBC has given me this platform to, you know, have this interview today to get my brand further out there during this crisis when sometimes the smaller businesses are overlooked. GWBC provides that platform for a business like mine, who is up against larger logistics competitors, for clientele to see me as a very viable logistics provider. So I am so grateful to GWBC, and I'll forever sing their praises now, from the rooftop.
Now, how did you become aware of that? Because some companies, some especially women-owned companies, aren't aware of them. How did you become aware of them? And if you could tell those women-owned businesses that aren't familiar the importance of getting involved with a group like them.
So I became aware of GWBC, of course, through my woman-owned certification through WeBank. And we know GWBC is an entity under WeBank. And so last year, I had heard just like through like, you know, people talking on social media about women-owned certification. And so I did my research to find different organizations that certify women-owned businesses, and GWBC stuck out to me with the things that they were offering and the corporate partners that they were partner with. They were definitely customers that I was targeting, and so I wanted to align myself with an organization that had those type contacts and could grow me or mentor me up in the direction that I need to be to do business with these clientele. And it has worked. Since me becoming a member of GWBC, I was recently awarded a large contract with Georgia Power for heavy haul services. So again, I will forever sing the praises for GWBC off the rooftop.
Now, this is for the people that aren't familiar. This is one of the big benefits for the small to mid-sized company is they give you the tools and the connections to penetrate these large organizations that for the little, the smaller firm, it's difficult to know what's what and the strategies and the techniques to kind of build relationships within these large companies, right? And they give you kind of like the secret map in, right? To help you kind of get through all the clutter and to stand out and to really have a real shot at doing business with these larger firms.
Right. So you hit that nail on the head. That has been one of the most comfortable things about me being a member of GWBC. When we have, say, the tables of eight or different networking events that GWBC has, if you've been targeting a specific customer, then you all are placed in the same room and the environment is very natural. The conversation is very natural. You don't feel forced. You just have to be prepared as a business owner to make that connection. Now, granted, you may not just, sign a contract or do business immediately then, but that relationship is formed with those type networking events. So through those type events with GWBC, I've been able to leverage those relationships and then foster them to eventually get some business there.
Right. It's not a magic wand that you just show up and you get these contacts. But if you're a good business person and you're proactive, there's a lot of opportunity at your fingertips if you, just deliver on what you're promising.
Right. That's right. That's right. So, and that's another piece with being a member of GWBC. They're going to give you the platform, but what you do with it is very important. So being a member of GWBC, yes, you're going to get that connect, but you need to follow up as a small business owner. A lot of small business owners, we are intimidated sometimes by larger corporations. So once that initial contact comes in, we don't know what to say after. You have to keep that. You have to strike while the iron is hot. You got to keep that fire going. Send a card or a lunch invite or a thank you note or something to let that corporate know and GWBC know that you're grateful for that connection.
Good stuff. Well, Hope.
I'm sorry.
Well, Hope.
No, you're good.
It sounds like you are doing what good business people do. They figure out a way. They don't say, I'm just going to sit here and wait this out. You just keep trying different things until you find things that work. And congratulations.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Now, if somebody wanted to learn more about your organization, whether it's be your normal day job of doing logistics, or if they want to take advantage of this training course, what is the websites to find you?
So my website is hdwhitelogistics.com. For consulting and training is hopewhiteconsulting.com. And then we also can be found at hdwhitelogistics on IG and as well as on Facebook and LinkedIn.
Well, good stuff. Thank you so much for sharing your story today, Hope.
Thank you.
All right. This is Lee Cantor. We will see you all next time on GWBC Radio.